LSU is going to have a tough time defending this rushing attack and this running back. It's very important that they shut him down and keep the ball out of his hands if they expect to have a chance in this game.
Yo, Kirk, you stole my pick.
I'm taking Bama. Roll Tide.
Alabama is ready to open this one up as they line up for the opening kick. He kicks off. Number 13 takes it at the 16. At the 40, across midfield. At the 40, at the 30, to the 20, to the 10. He returns it all the way to score. How about that return?
Great effort there by the returner, reading his blockers and evading the tacklers. And the results, 6 points.
So the kicking team will line up for the point after. And he hits the PAT. With under 5 minutes remaining in the first quarter of play, the score, LSU 7, Alabama nothing. Is lining up to kick this one off.
Is lined up for the kickoff.
Sends it sailing downfield. Number 8 fields it in the end zone. That return should help the offense out.
Yo, this kid is a sensational kick returner. He did a perfect job of reading his blocks on that kick return.
Almost perfect.
Eh, that's what I said. Almost perfect.
First and 10.
They'll set up shop at the 37. Up the middle. He jukes him. He's in, got away, and he's taken down at the 49-yard line.
And that one goes for a big, big first down.
You know, every time you run the ball successfully like that, that defense starts to creep up a little bit. That's when you go to the air, my friend.
First
over the top.
Ball on the 49.
First down. The Crimson Tide come out in the ace formation. They hand it off. Tackle made. At midfield, number 22 picks up a yard on the play, so that'll make it second down. It's second down.
Ball on the 50-yard line.
The Tigers line up with 6 defensive backs. Drops back to pass. It falls incomplete. He's unable to hit his receiver. He overthrew it.
And that's a throw he should make every single time.
It's third down and 9 to go. Number 12 lines up in the shotgun. Looking to throw. Steps up in the pocket. He lets it go. Caught! What a catch! And he's all the way down to the 23. There's an injured player on the field.
I didn't see what happened on the play, but you can only hope that this guy is able to shake it off and get back into the game.
We've got a first and 10. LSU comes out defensively with 6 defensive backs. Feeds it to the back. Makes a move. And they make the stop at the 20-yard line. And the halfback carries for a pickup of 3. It's 2nd and 7. One man backfield. He drops back. Under heavy pressure. Sheds a tackler. Throws back across field.
And that one's incomplete.
Number 8 was the intended receiver on the play. So that'll make it third down. So another third down upcoming for the offense. The Crimson Tide line up with 4 wideouts. Drops back to pass. Throw short. And it's the senior. He's taken down at the 19-yard line. Oh, man, he doesn't get the first. Great play by the defense.
Incredible. They saw that coming a mile away.
I think you got to give your quarterback a little bit more time, especially on third down.
They'll call on the field goal unit here. The kick is up, and it is good. Number 13 is back ready to receive, and boy, has he been the game breaker on special teams today. Kicks it away. Number 13 takes it to 15. Little shake and bake move. Now let's see what kind of success this offense can have as they come out onto the field for the first time today. They'll go to work at the 38.
First and 10.
LSU comes out with an I formation. They bring him down in the backfield.
Number 57 makes the tackle. 5-yard loss on the play.
They line up at the 33. Second down. Get him for a loss. No place to go that time, and the offense loses a yard or two.
Nice job of plugging up all the gaps and the possible cutback lanes by the defense.
We've got third and long here. Ball on the 32-yard line. Alabama lines up in a dime defense here. Under pressure, number 9 lost the ball. Number 9 recovers a loose ball, and that one's recovered by the cornerback.
Funny, because you usually don't see corners down there picking up loose balls. They're more worried about interceptions.
Well, you know what they say, great players make great plays, and that, my friend, is a great play.
They'll start this drive at the 19-yard line.
First and 10.
Number 22 alone in the backfield. Broke away from one. Look at the power. Tackle made at the 17-yard line. Number 22 gains about 2 yards on the run. They line up at the 17. It's second down. The Tide are lining up with 3 receivers, and they get him in the backfield for a loss. Well, folks, we just saw what can happen if you don't pick up all your blocks.
Man, that was an ugly nightmare from the beginning.
Third and 12. Ball on the 21-yard line. The Crimson Tide line up with 3 wide. Drop back to pass. Here's a quick throw. Complete. The receiver did come down with the ball, but he'll be short of the first down.
Yeah, I just can't figure out why you'd run that play on third down.
So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for 3. The holder's on the 26. This will be about a 36-yarder. It's up. And it's right down the middle. number 13, already has one kick return that went for a touchdown. Let's see if they kick it to him again. And it's off. And he can't hang on to the ball. Number 13 takes it at the 14. He let that one get away from him.
And Brad, anytime a player muffs a return like that, it sticks around in the back of his mind. You need just to forget about it and move on.
They'll take over at the 14. First and 10. High formation here. He drops back. Throws. They can't connect. Incomplete. How about that defensive call?
I love this call because you don't want the quarterback to get too comfortable back there. He'll tear you up.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 14. Number 9 comes to the line with 3 wide. Here's the give. Good move. Brought down at the 17. 3 yards there on the play. It's 3rd and 7. Ball on the 17-yard line. Number 34 lines up in the deep back, I formation. And they bring him down for a sack on the play. And they got him with a blitz.
Yeah, that time the pressure came from the safety position. Nobody picked him up, but he came up with a big-time play.
And we've come to the end of the first quarter with the score, LSU 7, Alabama 6. Here comes the punter looking to boot this one away. Number 38 awaits the snap. Number 3, back deep to return. He punts it away, and it's a great kick. Number 3 fields it at the 40. So he got a little on that return.
Well, Brad, early it looked like there was an opening there, but the seam closed quickly.
Kirk, you never listen to me. I've been telling you about that awesome team speed all day long. Aren't you going to listen to me?
It's 1st and 10, ball on the 44. 1st and 10. Setting up the play action. Waits till the last moment. And he's taken down at the 43. A good play fake that time.
Here, the play action was key. It held the linebackers there by the fake by the running back. And the running back did a very nice job of carrying out his fake.
And the quarterback did a tremendous job of the fake handoff, too.
1st and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. Alabama comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. Flags are all over the place, and they'll blow it dead.
Offsides, on the defense. 5-yard penalty.
So the offense will move a little bit closer with that penalty. First down.
Ball on the 38-yard line.
First down, looking to throw. Comes across the middle, catches it. Tackle made at the 23-yard line. And fellas, this is really turning into a very impressive drive.
3 first downs and counting on this drive, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building some momentum here. And more importantly, they've kept this defense on the field.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 23. The Tide are lining up with 3 receivers. There's the play fake. Number 12 throws it out there. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete.
I don't even think he saw the defense on that.
How does that kid expect to pick it off? He's got more tape on his hands than the heavyweight champ.
It's second down. Number 22, the lone back. Across the middle. He came down with it. Touchdown. Nice play call on that one to get the ball in the receiver's hand.
Yeah, the quarterback said, you want the ball, go get it. Did he ever. He got it and took it for 6.
Oh. They'll line up for the point after. And he tacks on the extra point. And with 4 minutes to go in the second quarter, our score, Alabama 13, LSU 7. Is ready to kick it away. Number 13 and number 8 back deep to return. He kicks it. Number 13 takes it at the 14.
Yo, the defense really stepped up to force that three and out on the last drive.
Yeah, the offense wasn't clicking on their last possession. We'll see if they have things figured out on this next drive.
They'll get the ball here at the 34. The Tide bring in the nickel package. It fly. Incomplete pass. Number 21 was the intended target, so that'll make it second down. It's second and 10. Ball on the 34-yard line. Number 9 with three wide receivers. Looks to pass. Wants to throw a screen. They can't connect. Incomplete. Number 2 was the intended receiver on that pass. That'll make it third down. From their own 34-yard line. Third and 10. This defense is in the dime. He steps up. Number 9 passes. He got it! And they tackle him.
Interesting call. The defense came with the heat that time. Problem was they couldn't quite get to the quarterback. And when you can't quite do something, that means the other guys will probably have a big play.
And you're right. That pass was good for a bunch of yards that time.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 28-yard line. LSU lines up in a double tight set. Setting up play action. Look out! That's a backward pass at the live ball. He's taken down at the 34. What do you think about that last turnover, Kirk?
Way to be heads up out there. That corner just made one heck of a play recovering that fumble.
They'll set up shop at the 34-yard line.
First and 10.
Number 12 comes to the line with three wide. Setting up the play action. Number 12 lets it go. It's complete. Oh, so close to breaking it. You got a lot of jersey on that play. Not too much argument about this call.
Holding on the offense. 10-yard penalty.
He didn't even try to hide it there. That was a blatant holding call.
They'll call that every time.
It's first and a mile. Ball on the 24. Alabama comes out in the shotgun. A little handoff. Tackle at the 28. 4 yards on that play. They line up at the 28. Second down. Play action. Stepping up. Throws. Caught. They complete the play action pass for a pickup of 3. Third and 13 coming up. Ball on the 31-yard line. Looking to throw. Across the middle. And he's got him on the run. And down he goes at the 49.
Now that's what you have to do on third and long.
Yep. He went right at him and hit him in the mouth. That's a great conversion to get the first down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 49. Inside handoff. A little juke. Brought down at the 41-yard line.
Pretty nice run there by the halfback.
Yeah, he wasn't fazed at all by the blitz. He just found a hole and picked up some good yardage.
Two minutes to go in the half. There's the play fake. He's wrapped up for the sack. So another third down upcoming for the offense. The Tide with four receivers, throws, and he's tackled right away. They couldn't get the first down.
Well, here they were hoping to get a few extra yards after the catch. Give the defense credit, they held him short.
Alabama ready to put this one away. Number 15 is back awaiting the punt. He gets it away and it's a skyrocket. Number 15 calls for the fair catch. The offense heads out onto the field. On their last series, they opted to try and convert a fourth down and they came up short. They line up at the 15. First down. They use four linebackers. He drops back. Moves up in the pocket. Looks like he's going to run. And he's tackled at the 27. He had a whole lot of room to run on that one.
When the pressure's coming from the inside and the quarterback can escape the pocket, it usually means he's going to have some room to run.
It's first and 10, ball on their own 27. LSU sets up in the eye. At the 30, LSU just took their first timeout. They line up at the 30. Second and 7 coming up here. The Tigers set up in the gun. Back to pass. Steps up in the pocket. Surveys the field. Number 9 guns it, and he's all the way down to the 43. LSU takes a timeout. That was their second timeout. They line up at the 43. First down. So we'll probably get one last heave to the end zone here before halftime. Number 9 lets it fly. Great concentration. We We've played a half of football here, and our score is Alabama 13, LSU 7. We're ready to start the second half. The teams are lined up for the kickoff.
Number three, back deep.
Kicks it off. Number eight takes it from the six. Time once again for this offense to come back out and start another drive. They line up at the 28. First down.
First and 10.
Number 12 lines up in the shotgun. Fakes to the back. He's looking. Number 12 with a bullet. Catches it. He gets hit out of bounds at the 46. Nice little pitch and catch with a wideout.
The quarterback and receiver spend a lot of time together. The coaches say they stay after practice just working on their timing, and right there it paid off.
They line up at the 46. First down. The Tigers line up with six defensive backs. They'll throw on first down. Throws it to the outside. Excellent open field tackle. The quarterback just lasered that one down the field, Coach.
Yeah, the defender had no shot at breaking that pass up.
From the 46-yard line, second and 2 yards to go. The offense lines up with three wide receivers. Scooped up by the defense. So the only man between him and the end zone makes the tackle. The linebacker made a heads-up play to recover that fumble.
Boy, I'll say he did. He knew right where to be.
And he took a shot on that play, Brad. Looks like his head might be still ringing a little bit.
Second down and 14. Ball on the 45. The Tigers come out in a shotgun. He drops back. They brought him down for the sack at the 40-yard line. Third down and long coming up here. LSU comes out in the shotgun. Stepping up, he looks. Number nine throws it out there. Incomplete pass. So the defense gets him to go three and out.
Good job here defensively forcing this incomplete pass.
Fourth and long.
The Tigers are lining up to punt it away. Number three is back deep to return.
Number three, back to return.
Hut! Number 38 punts it, and this is a wonderful kick. Number three takes it to 14. I don't think we'll see this offense get into a similar situation this time.
So you think they'll convert on fourth down if they go for it again?
Hey, why not? If you're having to go for it on fourth down a lot, you're not doing so hot, sweetheart.
They'll go to work at the 17-yard line.
First and 10.
The Tide are lining up with three receivers. With the misdirection, he jukes. They can't hang on to him. And they make the stop at the 27-yard line. A 10-yard gain.
Gain of 10 on the play.
second and inches. Ball on their own 27. The offense lines up with three wide receivers. Hands it to the back. Just one tackler. And he's tackled at the 29-yard line. And the tailback picks up the first down. First down.
Ball on the 29-yard line.
Play fake. He throws. This one is incomplete. Number 33 was the intended target on the play, so that'll make it second down. It's second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 29. Number 12 with three wide receivers. They go with a run. He jukes him. Tackle made at the 36-yard line. Number 22 gets 7 yards on the play. Third and three. Ball on the 36. The defense lines up in a dime. Number 12 delivers. Incomplete. Number three was the intended receiver on that pass. They're going to be forced to punt it away here. They line up to punt this one away. Number 13 will be the return man. He punts it. Number 13 fields it at the 26. And now we'll see the offense come out of the field for their next possession. Offense will start at the 26-yard line. LSU comes out with an I formation. They bring him down. It's second down.
Ball on the 20-yard line.
LSU lines up with three receivers. Back to pass. He's brought down at the 19. Third and long. Ball on the 19-yard line. Alabama comes out defensively with six defensive backs. Sets up play action, and they got it. Chalk one up for the linebacker.
It's hard to pick up this blitz because you never know where these guys are coming from.
You know, that's why I consider the offensive linemen some of the smartest people on the football field. And it didn't look like it on that play.
They come out in a punt formation. Number three is the deep man awaiting the return.
Number three, back deep to return.
Punts the ball away. Number three fields it at the 50. The defense did a good job against him the last time they had the ball, forcing the punt.
But remember, they had given up quite a few yards before forcing that punt. They might not be so lucky this time.
They'll go to work at the 49-yard line.
Start the drive at the 49-yard line. First and 10.
Number 22, alone in the backfield. Tries to juke. Breaks one. Tackle at the 44. A 5-yard gain.
5-yard gain on the play.
Second and five. Ball on the 44. So at the end of three quarters, it's only a one possession game with the score. Alabama 13, LSU 7. It's second down and five to go. Ball on the 44-yard line. Number 12 comes to the line with three wide. He's looking to pass. Steps up, looks, throws it out there. Complete.
Nice heads-up play by the quarterback.
Yep, they're moving the chains. That's a first down.
It's first down. Number 22, the lone back. First down, look at the throw. Lets it fly. It falls incomplete.
Kirk, what was that?
He just dropped it, Coach, plain and simple.
That was an abominable drop.
Abominable?
Yeah, I'm not sure what it means, but it just sounds bad.
They line up at the 37. It's second and 10. Alabama lines up in a shotgun set. Looks to pass. He throws it, and it's caught. They'll bring him down at the 36. Not a lot on that one.
1 yard gain on the play.
They line up at the 36. It's third down and nine to go. They'll throw again. Defense hasn't stopped them yet. Again, it's complete. A decent gain on the pass.
Yo, Kirk, good job by the quarterback here reading this play.
Yeah, the defense came with a blitz, and you're right. Great job by this young quarterback of recognizing the coverage and spotting the open man.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 26-yard line. Alabama goes with the ace set here. Defense looking for his first incompletion this drive. Great coverage, and it's intercepted. He's tackled at the 31-yard line. That interception breathes new life into this team.
I'm not quite sure I would have made that pass. It obviously wasn't open. This quarterback's got to be more conservative with the ball when they have the lead late in the game like this.
First and 10. Ball on their own 31.
First
and 10. LSU comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. And Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but whenever you can gain solid yardage, you're doing something right.
Second down, 4 yards to go. The defense sets up with five defensive linemen. He's hit and got away. And down he goes at the 44-yard line. So he picked up a few on that run.
Yeah, he did a nice job of using his blockers on that run. Really a nice read.
First and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. The Tigers line up in an I formation. He jukes him. Tackle at the 47. Gain of nine.
9 yard gain on the play.
From the 47-yard line. Second down. Drops back to pass. Can't wrap him up. It's intercepted. Brought down. at the 49-yard line.
He steps up and makes a big turnover.
Yeah, he just made a huge play right there. He knew what was coming all along.
You can't throw interceptions like that. You just can't.
So it's make or break time. Who's going to rise to the challenge? The Tide line up with a single set backfield. He drops back. Looking. He passes it. Complete. And he's taken down at the 47-yard line. 4 yards gain.
Gain of 4 on the play.
Second and 6. Ball on the 47. Alabama comes to the line with 3 wide. On the ground with the tailback. He's taken down at the 44. 3-yard gain by the running back. The Tigers call a timeout, and that was their first timeout. Third down and 3 coming up. Ball on the 44. The halfback with a carry. Good open field tackle. LSU will take a timeout, and they'll have 1 timeout left. We've got a 1st and 10. Ball on the 31. The Tide come to the line with their jumbo package. They give to the tailback. Makes a move. Brought down at the 26-yard line. Number 22 gains about 5 yards on the run. Second down and 5. Ball on the 26-yard line. The Crimson Tide line up in a goal line formation. Here's the give. Makes a move. And they make the stop at the 24-yard line. He plows ahead for a 2-yard gain. Well, I can't argue with this decision. Here are our players of the game. They'll line it up again on 3rd down. The Tide come out in the ace formation. They'll keep it on the ground again. Tackled for a loss. And the blitz might have caused that one.
Now the defense took a chance here. They overloaded that side of the ball, and the tailback had nowhere to go.
Looks like they've decided to go for it here. Nice play fake. He's looking. Throws it. Got it to his receiver. And he's taken down at the 16-yard line. The defense looked a little lost on that one, Kirk.
Yeah, they did, Brad. Nice recognition here by the quarterback to see that confusion and then take advantage of it.
We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. from the 18-yard line. Second down. Alabama will kneel on it here as they count the seconds down.